We're here now with Roger Krone, who's the CEO of Leidos. Now, some people may not be familiar with Leidos. Leidos is a successor, in effect, to a company called SAIC.
Right.
And you are now a publicly traded company.
Sure.
How large is it in terms of employees?
About 36,000.
36,000. And in terms of revenues?
12 billion.
$12 billion. Yeah. And you're headquartered in the Washington area?
Yeah, Reston, up by Dulles Airport. Right.
And remind me, your background is what?
I'm an engineer. I'm an aerospace engineer, 40 years in the industry, worked for a couple other defense contractors.
And you went to school at in Texas, you undergraduate?
Georgia Tech, and then a master's at University of Texas, and then an MBA
from Harvard.
Some school in Boston.
Right? Harvard. Okay, Harvard Business School. Okay. Right. So what exactly does Leidos do?
Yeah, well, we're in four areas. We're mostly a government technology company. We do defense, intelligence, civil infrastructure like FAA, and then we have a healthcare business. We don't provide healthcare. We're not a provider, but we do information and facilitation around health and health topics.
All right. So, how many employees do you have in the Washington area?
Between Virginia, D.C., and Maryland, about 13,000.
Are they working from home, or are they coming to the office? What are you telling your employees?
Yeah, just yesterday we updated our reaction to the coronavirus, and we encouraged even more employees to work at home. On a normal day, we'll have about 20% of our workforce will telecommute, and that's across the globe. We're big in Australia, the UK, and the Middle East. And yesterday I put out a directive that said, where possible, work at home. We're trying to minimize the human-to-human interaction to reduce the spread.
Any of your employees contracted this yet?
No, we're very fortunate that hasn't happened, but we anticipate that we'll have employees that will contract it.
Now, obviously the most important thing is not money and finances, it's health, but just for the purposes of illustration, at the peak recently, your stock price was at what level?
Well, we were about 125.
And what is it now?
Well, I don't know this morning. Yesterday, we were down about 85, although the market's up about 1,000, so we're probably about 90.
All right, so you lost a fair amount of market value, but you assume it'll come back?
It will come back, sure.
Okay, so what are you personally doing to avoid getting this virus?
I'm taking the normal precautions. We've canceled staff meetings. We're doing staff meetings virtually. We've obviously done hand sanitizer, things like that. I will be working a day or two from home, like I've asked our employees to do. We're doing a lot more virtual than human to human. And then, you know, at home and in the community, we're spending more time in the house and, you know, less interaction.
Now, you have a lot of your clients are federal government related entities. So are they coming to work, the federal employees that you're often dealing with, or are they working from home now?
Well, so far, we've had no facilities that have been shut down. We do a lot of IT. We have, for some of our customers, given them more bandwidth so that they have the option to expand their work-at-home program. But as of this morning, all of our customers are at work, and all of those government agencies are open for business.
Okay, so today, the impact on your company over the next 6 months or so, I assume you'll expect some decline in revenue or earnings?
You know, it's kind of interesting. We could anticipate that, David, but we haven't seen it yet. In fact, what's been a little unique is what we have done is we've canceled trade shows and travel and trips, and those are usually what we call indirect expenses. Those are things that, you know, go into overhead and G&A. And like for me, I was supposed to be at a trade show Monday and Tuesday, and at the J.P. Morgan conference on Wednesday. So I canceled out of all three of those. I spent three more days in the office. I did a lot of things that I had been putting off. This week, I'm actually a little bit more productive than I would normally be. And we're actually seeing that across the enterprise. We're spending less on indirect costs. We're doing more for our customers and more direct charging. We don't expect that that may be maintained, right? There will be a time where a facility or two will be shut down. But so far, the economic impact to Leidos has been neutral to maybe slightly positive, actually.
So have you had to lay people off yet?
No.
And you expect to have to do that or not?
We don't expect to do that. And we went through the government shutdown a year ago. You know, we had a 33-day government shutdown. We were able to redeploy. during the shutdown to parts of the company where the customer was open. We have a employee a fund that we use to help bridge employees who otherwise would be furloughed. You actually can donate paid time off into the fund, and we've done that. We actually have a balance in the fund, so we're not anticipating any significant layoffs.
Okay, so it took me a while to remember the four letters SAIC. When I finally memorized them, you changed the name.
Yeah, we did.
What was wrong with SAIC? I got that name down, but why did you change it? What does Leidos mean?
Well, Leidos is cut from the middle of the word kaleidoscope. It's a an artificial name that was created so that we could have the copyright and internet domain. The name SAIC actually was given to part of our company that we spun out into a separate agency. So there's actually a separate company that's also publicly traded that bears the name SAIC.
So do you have any recommendations for your employees about what they should do in light of what's going on?
Yeah, I think our recommendations have been pretty clear, which is you should do what you're comfortable with. If you feel you're at risk and you want to work at home, please do that. Take the appropriate precautions, modify your work schedule, take care of yourself first. We're a people company more than a product company, and so the health and well-being of our employees is paramount. And we have a Krone working group that meets. My executive leadership team, we have a phone call every day. Like I had a question last night, there was an employee who was concerned about coming in and working in a particular area, and the direction was if they're not comfortable, well, then they ought to work at home, and we'll take care of the rest.
So I assume you don't shake anybody's hands anymore?
Not many.
Not many?
Not many.
Okay, and I noticed you kind of broke your foot or something. What happened there?
Well, I'm a runner, and I had a repetitive stress injury. So but I'm doing fine.
Not related to the virus.
Not related to the virus. I should be back up running again.
So you would say that this is something you're dealing with, you're managing through it. At this moment, you don't see any deleterious effects on your company long term.
That's correct. Correct. And I would emphasize to you, to everybody that's out there, is that we're going to be okay. We'll get through this. If they're short term, maybe we wish we could do more testing or something, but there are already vaccines in formulary. They'll get them through stage one, stage two trials. There will be a vaccine. We will get through this. We'll return to whatever the new normal is.
I see. Roger, thank you very much for coming in, and good luck on your foot and
great,
other things you're doing.
Thanks. Okay? Thanks for the opportunity to talk.
I won't shake your hand, but thank you very much.
You're welcome.